excuse me, what's the line for?
The Lego shop.
Oh, new Lego shop. Brand new.
Brand new.
So, the specials? Because one of them, Bandai, I think, in a body judgment.
I think they do Lego specific for this store.
Oh, yes. Ah, special one.
Guarantee you won't be cheap.
Because I got a couple of these ones, yeah. And they're all Lego. But it's a big line. It's a big line, so it's the first day. Yeah. I have a couple of boys, and they got never enough Legos. Thank you.
your pharmacist for information. Nivea Rich Nourishing Body Lotion. Dermatologically approved formula with almond oil.
us from the whims of other people's approval and against the unpredictability of life. This is not a reason to keep our identity secret or to be suspicious of others. Instead, it implies that we should be cautious with how we place our trust. Instead of shouting your goals to the world, share them with the people who will truly support you and get your vision. Doing so will serve to fortify your hopes and dreams. As a result, you'll have more resilience while facing challenges and rejection. Your inner fortitude might serve as a shield of perseverance and drive. Marcus Aurelius praised the virtue of patience throughout his works. He realized that it's best to wait before telling others about our ideas, since doing so too soon might have a negative impact on our success. The temptation to take short routes or make hasty judgments increases when we are anxious to make our intentions known. Let's say you've always dreamed of being your own boss. You've put in countless hours and months of preparation. Still, you haven't released it yet. If you give in to the urge to announce your intentions before you're ready, you may move hastily without giving due consideration to all of the potential outcomes. To be patient in this situation implies to hold off on taking action until after you've given your plans careful consideration. Putting off telling others about your intentions gives you more time to think them through, collect what you need, and make sure everything you do contributes to your long-term goals. This calm method, which has its origins in Stoic philosophy, improves the chances of success. The charm of surprise people with their success is described in the book, The Art of Surprise. If you don't let others in on your intentions, you might surprise them by going above and beyond what they expected of you. Marcus Aurelius understood the importance of this unexpected factor. Think of the talented musician who hid their desire to become a virtuoso from everyone and worked tirelessly on perfecting their craft in secret. When they finally got to showcase their talents on a big platform, the crowd went wild. Their success was much more impressive because of the element of surprise, and it certainly made an effect on everyone who saw it. Keeping their plans under wraps until they are ready to be revealed generates excitement and interest. You let your deeds do the talking for you, and you may confidently and graciously announce your achievements at the appropriate moment. Similar to the development of an identity, new ideas require time to achieve and change. You risk the harsh atmosphere of criticism and skepticism when you announce your goals too early. Marcus Aurelius advises us to give our thoughts plenty of time to grow and flourish in goal rather than appreciating the process of getting there. Marcus Aurelius' Stoic philosophy serves as a timely reminder that developing oneself is an ongoing endeavor. When we keep our plans to ourselves, we can concentrate on small victories along the way, rather than letting them derail us. Take the example of someone who wants to learn to play an instrument. They may get too focused on the final goal of playing difficult pieces perfectly if they talk about their aspirations to become a virtuoso all the time. But if they keep their goals to themselves and work on improving day by day, they will find great reward in their accomplishments. If you can keep your plans to yourself, you can enjoy the moment more fully. We recommend.
Yes. Long way to go. So you do markets in Cairns?
No, I live here.
Ah, you live here?
Yes.
Ah, you're originally from Cairns.
Yes.
All right. So what's the name of your people?
We are Barbara Mivinji and
Kukuyalanji. So and who live on the hills from Cairns? It's Kuranda.
Yes, that's right.
I got a friend from Kuranda. And what's the tribe there?
The Kuranda people are the Jabagai.
Jabagai.
I'm just going to show you the layout.
Oh, yeah. Somebody says 90,000, not 65. It's good 90. Yeah. How much you sell them? $40. Are you here only for the day or just today?
Yeah, today.
Yeah.
It was here yesterday.
Are you from Sydney?
I'm from up Lismore
way. Lismore way, alright.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, Lismore. So you work there, jury, or what's your tribe name?
My tribe name is Warrabah.
Warrabah, yeah.
Bundle,
all right. Yeah. So I like this one. Yeah. So you got extra life? Extra life?
Yeah.
Just show me, I'll check if it's.
Yeah.
Because some of them bigger, some of them smaller, you know? Yeah. Sometimes mediums like a big. Here. Yeah, it's medium.
Oh, well, it's medium.
So if it's medium, I can fit them in the large.
No,
yeah. Extra large is too big. Yeah, it's too big. I just need the large.
Large.
Yeah. But this is different. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a different design.
Yeah.
Yeah, just extra large. All the large are gone.
Yeah.
We have larges in the other one.
Yes,
that's too big.
It's what I say. Some of them like medium, big, but and this one, yeah, it's a bit of small. Yeah.
I think we got that one large. No. But it's they're different.
No, I
like that. You like that survival? Yeah.
Sorry about that.
No, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm a bit of artist, you know, I know he's okay.
There's a no responsible less.
Can we fix that? From here?
Oh, yeah, we can.
Remotely manage and secure PCs even if the OS is down.
Yeah, the box system is wild.
But Intel did it.
Thank you. Guns in the ground.